I am sharing this project that includes a lot of tea dyed fabric, laces, some found objects, but most importantly, letters that my father wrote to my mother during World War II. My name is Pink, and I call my channel Two Old Crows Mixed Media. I hope you will take a moment and subscribe. And of course, that notification bell does allow you to know when I upload additional content. That I actually received from my daughter. A gift was inside it. It was a silver tin, and I have recreated it to provide it a rustic tin that I am including in it moments forgotten. The story is on the back. All of the handwriting is from letters written to my father, to my mother during World War II. He was wounded serving during the Battle of the Bulge. He was in the army, and he spent over a year in an army hospital before returning home. My parents celebrated 65 years of marriage prior to his death in 2007. So let's just take a look at what I have included in this little box. You can see here the lid shows an inspector seal for the letters that were previewed or censored prior to them coming to my mother. And inside is a little scroll, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. But this is kind of the key to their 65-year marriage. And the tin has the lace bottom. This is a tea bag that I've used for the cover. And inside, as we look at the first page, is a picture of a World War II couple, and I view this as the goodbye. And this was the date of a letter that my father wrote on January 16th in 1943. This is a list of wedding anniversaries, and they celebrated all of these up to the 60th. Once he left, many letters were written. I have so many to choose from. And this is his handwriting and the love that he was sending in each of these letters to my mother before he went overseas. And of course, she was receiving those letters and was pregnant when he left, and my oldest brother was born during the time he was overseas. Here is some letters that he wrote in 1944. Now, my father served in combat. He was in the infantry in the army and was reporting to General Patton and was at the Battle of the Bulge where he was wounded. And after he was wounded, my mother, of course, received notification from the casualty branch of the army. And fortunately, he survived his wounds, but he did spend 1 year in an army hospital in California. And many of the letters were written from that hospital talking about his recovery, talking about all the different surgeries he was having, etc. And they survived that and continued to lead a happy life, but it was always a little stained with the injuries and the pain that he suffered throughout his entire life. So that kind of tells their story. And this little scroll I made to represent the end of his life, which occurred in 2007. The little heart just talks about the love that he had for my mother throughout those entire years. This is the year that he died in 2007. And of course, he was considered a war hero. He had two Bronze Stars and, of course, a Purple Heart. And this represents his 21-gun salute that he received at his funeral. So this was a very personal project for me. Reading these letters has not been easy. I have read a few, but it's difficult. So I wanted to memorialize those, and this is what I created. So I hope you enjoyed. And that completes the walkthrough of my Moments Forgotten.